Let's go through the various setups required for rebates. On the sales and receivable setup table, we've introduced two new fields, rebate calculation, the two options being on post and on document. On post will insert rebate value entries when the sales document gets posted, whereas on document will calculate the rebate values at the document level, allowing the user to view or change the rebates at the document level. This is based on this setting over here, which is allowing, in this case, I'm allowing the salesperson to change rebates at the document level. Next, we introduce the customer rebate groups. This is where we define the group and the rebate structure. The rebates are a combination of the sales code and the type. So types that are available to us are all items, item specific, or item rebate group. And sales types available to us is all customers, customer, and customer rebate group. It is worth mentioning at this point that sales rebates are accumulative, which means if there is more than one valid rebate based on the setup of sales code and type, they will be added together. We can also specify whether it's a percentage or a base rebate amount. In this instance, I've specified $100 against this combination of sales code and item at $100. We have start and an end date. It is also worth mentioning that rebates do work for foreign currency as well. Next, we have the rebate posting groups. This is where we specify the rebate account and the rebate accrual account in the balance sheet. I've split these into two separate accounts for each option. However, you can use the same account if you so choose. The changes to the customer card allow us to specify a customer rebate group, and the changes to the item card allow us to specify an item rebate group. All right, let's have a look at the behavior of rebates on a sales order. So I'm going to create a new sales order. And I'm going to use two items that I have previously set up already. So this is the first one. I've set up a sales price of $2,500. And you can see that $25 has been calculated as the rebate amount. And this is a drill through onto the sales line rebates table, which explains to us how it was calculated. So it's used a 1% rebate percentage in order to calculate the $25 rebate. If we have a look at the next item, a sales price of $3,000, and it's calculated a rebate value of $130. So in this instance, this is what I mean by it being accumulative, in that it's using the static rebate unit amount of $100 for this item, as well as the 1% across all items. If I was to introduce a discount, you'll notice how the rebate value changes. So this is working on the line amount, excluding GST, and not the unit price field. Let's post this document and have a look at the various ledgers that get created for us. Right, so this is the order that I've posted. You can see that the rebate amount and the net line amount fields are available to us on the posted sales lines. If we go to actions and find entries, we can see the changes that have occurred during the posting routine. The first one to note is the general ledger entries that have been created. I've got entries for rebates posting through into my expense and over here into my accruals account. If we have a look at the value entry table, we'll notice that the rebate amount is available to us from the value entries, and a drill through is available onto the rebate value entries table. And lastly, the change has been added to create the rebate value entries, which are available and linked to this document, and we can see exactly how the rebates were calculated from that posting.